artificial intelligence.
Machine learning.
The metaverse.
The metaverse.
As Niels Bohr said, prediction is difficult, especially when it's about the future. So keeping that in mind, let's talk about some events that will happen on Earth before 2050. Predicting the future can be hard. As Moore's law suggests, the power of computers doubles every 2 years, and its costs will continue going down. This can be made clear with the sudden progress we have made in technology in the last 10 years or more. So our future might have new technologies we wouldn't have thought of now. But there are a few things we can actually hope to see happen. Let's talk about 7 events that will happen leading up to 2050. Number 7. Human settlement on Mars. Building a human settlement on Mars isn't a sci-fi dream anymore. We are already witnessing a new space age, where several organizations are eyeing to go to the Red Planet. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk is leading the charge of this vision by funding and building Starship, a fully reusable heavy-lift launch vehicle. To establish a human colony on the Red Planet, you'll need an insane amount of cargo capacity. For life to become multiplanetary, megatons per year in orbit are required. Each Starship could transport over 100 tons every voyage, implying that every 10 ships could give 1 megaton to orbit per year. NASA is getting ready to go back to the Moon with its Artemis program, which will serve as a precursor for human landings on Mars. NASA plans to develop and test advanced technologies and test them on the Artemis mission. With the data gathered from building a settlement on the Moon, humans will be well prepared for getting to the Red Planet. Any endeavor to establish a society on Mars must consider several special requirements, and satisfying these demands will involve colonists relying significantly on modern technologies. But that itself is the beauty of our human civilization. We always beat the odds. The future might hold lots of opportunities for us. Not only will the settlement on Mars generate millions of jobs, but also lay down the base for further exploration of the solar system. So by 2050, most of us, or our children, might be already working on Mars, or taking a vacation on the Red Planet for sure. Before proceeding, be sure to leave a like for the algorithm and subscribe to our channel clicking the bell. This will encourage us to do better, and you'll never miss any of our weekly videos. Number 6. The merger of AI and humans. As mentioned before, keeping in mind the current rate of growth of technology, it's inevitable to approach the integration of AI in our everyday life and even within ourselves. The idea might seem a bit natural to some and shocking for others, but it is something that is already in the making. We are already witnessing AI systems increasing in our everyday lives. Whether it is Google giving you suggestions or Alexa in your homes, companies like Tesla are already close to achieving self-driving cars. Facial recognition helps to unlock our phones, voice assistants are making our everyday life comfortable, and the list goes on. AI systems are increasing every year. The relationship between humans and AI is something of a dance. This relationship between civilization and technology is yin and yang, with every significant advancement followed by the possibility of harm. AI, for example, promises to eliminate monotonous, repetitive chores, allowing us to focus on higher level, more satisfying pursuits. It aids with a variety of efficiency endeavors, including fraud detection, and it can even create outstanding artworks and compose symphonies. But it also presents us with a big potential danger. The conflict between the intrinsic desire to build and use AI-enabled technology and the possibility that it may transcend humanity is reasonable. This stew drives the dance and feeds the continuing industry conversation about how to effectively use and govern AI. In essence, the debate is about who takes the initiative. People are in control today, while AI is still in its infancy. But the concerns are about who will lead the dance in the future. A possible solution to this would be the merger of humans and AI. AI will transform our scope of possibilities in ways we are just now seeing, leading to a blending of man and machine. Elon Musk, for one, feels that this is both a workable and necessary course of action, even though the near-term aim of his company, Neuralink, is to construct a brain-computer interface that can aid people with certain health concerns. He has a bigger vision for the long run. He believes this interface will be required for humans to keep up with increasingly sophisticated AI. Such a breakthrough might reshape the interaction between people and machines, giving rise to a greater level of AI-powered intellect. In effect, the dancers will merge. This would have far-reaching repercussions for religion, among other things. What does it mean in religious terms if God created people in God's image and humans built robots in our image? And what exactly is a combined creation? The answer to all these questions lies in our future ahead. Number 5. Nuclear fusion. For over 50 years, nuclear power plants have generated energy through fission, a process in which neutrons attack heavy materials such as uranium, producing heat in the process. Nuclear fusion, on the other hand, operates on the inverse principle. Light atomic nuclei are squeezed under tremendous pressure and heat of fusion reactors to generate heavier ones, releasing energy in the process. The procedure must be tuned such that it produces more energy than it uses. Fusion might be used to generate power economically if the energy profit is significant enough and sustained. Fusion, a type of nuclear energy produced when lightweight atoms combine, is the process at work at the center of every star, releasing vast amounts of energy. Researchers have been attempting to harness fusion and replicate it in a controlled manner on Earth. If they are successful, they will supply the world with a safe, sustainable, ecologically responsible, and plentiful energy source. Today, several nations are involved in some kind of fusion research, led by the European Union, the United States, Russia, and Japan, with active programs also underway in China, Brazil, Canada, and Korea. Initially, fusion research in the United States and the Soviet Union was tied to the development of atomic weapons, and it remained classified until the Atoms for Peace conference in Geneva in 1958. Following a breakthrough at the Soviet tokamak in the 1970s, fusion research became big science. Nuclear fusion has been studied for decades, but research has now reached a tipping point, with scientists constructing an experimental reactor that might one day show that fusion can be used commercially to generate electricity. Nuclear fusion energy has several potential benefits, including being a long-term, sustainable, cost-effective, and safe energy source for power generation. Fuel is cheap and abundant in nature, and the quantity of long-lived radioactive waste and greenhouse gases created by fusion is negligible. In other words, we are close to achieving a system of unlimited clean energy that could finally solve all global warming issues. Number 4. Extinction of Chocolate. How How do you cope with bad news if the bad news is losing one of the finest methods of dealing with bad news? Cacao plants, it appears, are becoming increasingly vulnerable to fungal disease and climate change. Climate change may intensify coastal floods, exacerbate wildfires and hurricanes, promote the spread of insect-borne illnesses, ruin coral reefs, endanger hundreds of animal species, and degrade our existing way of life. But would it endanger chocolate? That would be unacceptable. Fungal illness is not a recent threat. In 2010, the development of witch's broom, frosty pod, and other beautifully named fungal diseases virtually killed cocoa plants in their native Central America. Scientists are concerned that these fungi may spread to other regions of the world and wreak havoc on the cherished chocolate-producing plant. The issue is that cocoa plants are extremely sensitive. They require highly specialized rainforest-like circumstances, such as relatively consistent temperatures, high humidity, plentiful rain, nitrogen-rich soil, and wind protection. While extinction predictions may be a bit early, these tendencies show that unless something is done, the future of chocolate may be in jeopardy. One option is to take action on climate change. But what if we don't manage to reverse climate change? Can we do anything else to save chocolate? Well, Mars Incorporated may have the solution. Not only has the company pledged to reduce its carbon emissions, it is also working with external scientists to develop genetically modified cacao plants that can resist fungal diseases and live in a broader set of conditions. A lot can happen in 40 years, and experts now warn that cocoa plants are in danger, but they aren't forecasting that they would vanish off the face of the earth. Regardless, the dangers facing chocolate show how vulnerable our food supply is. While the thought of eating GMO, genetically modified organisms, chocolate, may be a bit scary for some people, it's still a better option than living in a world without any kind of chocolate, right? Number 3. Climate change solved. Solving climate change might be a bit of a dream for now. As things stand today, a lot more work needs to be done to solve this existential problem. Positive efforts towards solving the problem of climate change are already being taken today. Today, companies like Tesla have brought a revolution of electric cars. In the coming years, electric cars will be a lot cheaper and affordable for everyone. At that point, there'll be a massive shift to electric vehicles as they are cleaner, quieter, and require way less maintenance. Heating and conditioning in homes and offices would have also gone electric. Heat pumps powered by electricity will replace gas-burning furnaces. On top of that, we will shut down power plants using coal and gas for energy. Nuclear energy might be the way for humanity to solve and minimize our carbon offset. Today, many countries are moving toward nuclear energy as it is clean, reliable, and cheap. There'll be massive solar farms also, built to generate electricity. In the future, batteries will become more and more efficient, making storage of energy more easy and effective. Humanity will also become a multi-planetary species, so there'll be no overpopulation problem on the planet. This will be a huge decrease in the carbon offsets as compared to 10 billion living people on Earth. Today, we can see an increase in the number of technological startups coming with new ideas to tackle the climate crisis. With collective human efforts and technology, humanity will have the best chance of fighting the climate crisis. So let's put our efforts in the right direction. Number 2. Antibiotics will stop working. According to a recent study, antimicrobial resistance, AMR, will cause 300 million premature deaths and cost the global economy up to $100 trillion, 64 trillion pounds, by 2050. According to the estimate, the world's GDP will be 0.5% lower by 2020 and 1.4% lower by 2030, with over 100 million premature deaths. This issue extends beyond health policy, and governments should act now on a simple macroeconomic basis. Antibiotic resistance is increasing at such a rapid rate that they risk losing their effectiveness entirely. So medical procedures such as cesarean sections, joint replacements, and chemotherapy may become too dangerous to perform soon. And unless serious action is taken soon, drug-resistant infections will kill 10 million people per year by 2050. Drug-resistant infections are suspected to be on the rise as a result of the overuse of medications such as antibiotics and antifungal therapies to treat minor ailments such as the common cold. Drug resistance develops with usage, and certain illnesses become incurable. Antibiotic usage in pig farming is also frequent, according to research, because poor living circumstances need such treatment to avoid illness spreading among livestock. And this is passed down to humans via pork eating, boosting resistance levels even further. In the United Kingdom, cattle receive 45% of all antibiotics. According to the report, if no action is taken now, the cost of antibiotic failure will be $100 trillion by 2050, and antimicrobial resistance may soon become a larger threat to humanity than cancer is today. Number 1. We find extraterrestrial life. Finding extraterrestrial life has been a quest for humans since we first developed modern modes of communication. Even though organizations such as Search for Extraterrestrial Life, or SETI, have been actively looking out for aliens for over a decade, we have had no luck finding them. The universe is big, with trillions of possible habitable planets, and there can be various reasons we haven't been able to contact them. The Fermi paradox tries to answer this very question, but there is a possibility of finding alien life that too is in our solar system. Though it won't be an intelligent life, this is because by 2050, we would become an interplanetary civilization and will send rovers and even humans to planets and moons in our solar system. And moons like Europa will be the prime spot for humanity to find extraterrestrial life. We already know that life on Earth requires three things: a source of energy, a liquid solvent like water, and elements that can form complex molecules and organisms. Jupiter's moon Europa might have all three things. There might be bacterial life thriving on one of those moons. Life has formed and developed on Earth in even the harshest of conditions. Today we know life can form and thrive in the most extreme environments on Earth. By 2050, humanity can send and land robots or humans on these strange worlds and look for signatures of life. Whether or not we make contact with intelligent aliens is up for debate, but we will surely be able to detect at least bacterial life in our solar system, if it exists. So, what do you think about the aforementioned events? What kind of world do you dream about in 2050?